April in Venice, Louisiana, in Plaquemines Parish is a great time to fish. It's a transition time. Things are warming up. You're usually dealing with a high Mississippi River, and you have to go fish the outer edges. And that's what we're doing today with Captain Anthony Randazzo of Paradise Plus Outfitters. We've got a morning where some weather is coming in. We're going to play Beat the Clock, and Captain Anthony is a fantastic guide with lots of knowledge, and he's going to put us on a ton of redfish today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. When you come down to Plaquemines Parish, you're going to get in on great fishing, but when you fish with one of our great captains, you're also going to get outstanding lodging and meals. And that's what we have here at Paradise Plus Outfitters. Came down the night before, Captain Bernie cooked us an exceptional dinner. Then we got a super nice sleep in the lodge, got up to a great breakfast, and then headed to Cypress Cove Marina in Venice, Louisiana to launch the boat and head to the east side of the Mississippi River. It was supposed to be a very windy day today, but as of now, the wind isn't blowing very strong. So Captain Anthony takes us on the east side to a point where he likes to fish, and that's where our day starts. Anyway, there's one thing about this area that has never changed. This stubble where these canes are, it's always gonna hold fish.
It does, and it doesn't really matter, you know, how high the river gets. You can have tons of water coming downstream. The fresh water, you know, is just as high a concentration as any other time of the year right now. And these fish find spots that have structure and bait, and they're here. They wanna be here, and they're here in large numbers. People can come down here and catch 30, 40, 50 of these a day in the springtime. And you know, a lot of people write this area off when the river's up high, but you don't have to count it out. There's tons of fish to catch here.
We always talk about that water may be a little bit dirty on the top, but on the bottom, some good salt water down there. And with these redfish, they don't even have to be in necessarily salty or clean water.
That's for sure. And if you find one this time of the year, you can hang around that area. You can bet there's quite a few more. There's a lot of days you drop the anchor and you don't have to go 10 feet. Once you catch the first one.
Nice red.
And he sure hit it with a whole lot more energy than his size accounts for, but.
He did knock it pretty good though, didn't he?
Yep, another tasty morsel.
Oh, I got one.
Another notch on the counter.
No, I don't. I have what you caught.
One of those Roseau canes.
It felt good though. Remember when you said yours felt good?
Absolutely.
All right, this is the difference between fishing with live shrimp and fishing with plastic right now. The difference is very simple. I have a stick.
And that's He's got a fish stick.
Fish stick.
Yes.
So yeah, that's the difference.
We grew up on those.
That's why I'm going into the live bait bucket. Nice fish.
Thank you.
There you go.
It's better when the tide starts going out. Oh, there's a nice red.
Yeah, that's a good red for sure.
Love it when they jump a little bit. At least it makes me feel like I'm catching a snook or a trout.
You got the spot award there, buddy.
Well, the last couple have had quite a few spots on them.
Yeah.
But that dude ate another lemon peel ghost minnow tipped with shrimp. Water's a little dirty here, so a little extra scent on there is really making the fish find this plastic in the water. Sometimes I like to use a plastic that's, you know, about this size just because it creates a nice silhouette in the water. It's not too big, not too small, but the shrimp smell just complements it perfectly. These fish are just cruising around in here, finding their way along these hard bottoms. We're out away from the river because the river's high this time of the year. It's April right now, and these fish are pretty close to the open water on the coastal bays. And they can find a nice increase in salinity when the tide comes in every day, and they're just feeding as the bait fish comes in with that better water. And there's lots and lots of fish this size around to be caught. You can catch a limit just about every day this time of the year, and you can literally throw back as many as you want, but we'll try to catch a few more and go see if we can find something different. Hi, I'm Captain Anthony Randazzo and this Paradise Plus Guide Service. We're out here catching a world of redfish today. It's that time of the year, beautiful April spring weather. Everybody's down here having a great time. We've got lots to offer, from food, lodging, and great fishing to just good times. Whether you're a corporate customer looking to do some entertaining or you're an individual looking to get away with some buddies or some family, this is a great place to do it. We can accommodate 27 folks here any given night of the week. We've got 10 boats running every day. Got some really great captains, a great cook at the lodge to take care of all your dining needs, and you know, a really, really cool place that's unique to this area. It's got lots of outdoor areas to kick back and relax in between fishing, lots of places to socialize with other fishermen, and just a really good place to kick back and let all the steam off that you build up back at the office.
Oh, this one did too.
Mine took the bait right off. That one's coming out the water like a trout.
I tried to put a little bit of heat on him since I pulled the hook on a couple earlier. I just wanted him to stay
on. Yeah, you weren't going to miss that one, were you?
No.
About 18 inches.
Yes, sir. There's a lot of days where we ride all over looking for this size fish because we don't want to eat the great big tough ones. We're just looking for these tender morsels. If I'm gonna eat redfish, it's gonna be something in the 16 to 20 inch range. Nothing better, it's like baby veal.
You got another one.
Yeah.
I'm just glad to be out for the boat ride.
It's another twin.
Nice one,
They're
bud.
All like cookie cutters. Oops, sorry, one after another. Same size, same bait, same yum-yum at the dinner table.
Nice. All spring long, all you want. That's what makes this place so special.
It gets going strong in March, and you know, we pretty much can catch them throughout the year, but we actually ease off of them in April and May and June to target trout quite a bit, and then we'll you know, catch a few redfish after we trout fish each day.
That's the one thing about this. If you want to come down and catch a redfish, you can catch them literally 12 months a year down here in Venice. And people love to come catch redfish, and no matter what month you come, Anthony, you can target them.
Absolutely.
Got that one.
Yes, sir. He's in the same exact spot, way off the cane.
That's one thing people need to remember when they fish these canes, is that way off the canes means you're still fishing on stubble.
That's for sure. The footprint of these shorelines has receded tremendously, but there's still structure under the water. We're gonna let this guy grow up.
Yep.
He'll be a keeper in the fall.
You know, when people fish down here, Anthony, one of the best things you could probably have is an old map or an old GPS card.
Absolutely.
That would show you, because where we're fishing right now, 20 years ago, we couldn't be fishing here.
Absolutely. The original point is 100 yards away from the boat, out in the open water here. And it's always changing. Everything's getting smaller and smaller. But those old maps are key. If you can get an old GPS card, hang on to it, because it's like gold. You'll see some stuff on there that you never would have been able to figure out otherwise.
Yeah. Folks, you're not going to believe this. After days and days I caught one. Officially caught one.
Way to go, K-Fed.
I mean, I caught one. I mean, I actually caught him. We're both fishing with soft plastics and tipping it with shrimp. But I'm so happy I caught him. He's probably close to 16 inches, but I'm letting him go for luck. Fun fishing here in Venice. Everything is back open. Guides are ready to have you come down this summer. Nothing more safe for your family to do than come down here and fish this summer. It's going to be a great summer of fishing, and I think it's, you know, we've had a couple of years of extremely high rivers and things like that. River's high right now, but conditions are setting up for just an absolutely super year down here, and you need to come see Captain Anthony and his crew. I'll tell you what, the lodge is outstanding. Food is absolutely amazing. Chef Bernie does a great job with that, and it's just another one of the great gems that we have here in Plaquemines Parish. So the action's not very good at this first spot. We catch a few fish and we're noticing that the wind is not blowing nearly as strong as the forecast indicated. But we also know there's some severe weather coming in late this evening, but we do have an opportunity to get out. In fact, this is the day that that freak storm comes up in the Gulf and the tragedy with the Secor power happens. So Anthony calls one of his guides on the radio who made a run out to the islands, and they didn't catch any fish. We were heading out that way to go try. So we pull back on the throttle next to this point. Anthony's like, well, they have some redfish here sometimes. Let's fish here, and then we'll make a move from there and decide what we're gonna do. Well, once we stopped on this point, there was no moving the rest of the day. It was one redfish after the other, and this action is as good as it gets. And that's exactly where I caught mine.
Way to go, bud.
I don't know what I have here. I think I have a red. Can't tell if it's kind of pulling like a sheep's head. Can't really tell. I think it's a red. The way he's coming in now. Yep, that would
that's
be a
another red.
Nice red. That didn't take long.
Not at all.
Well, one thing we found over here, which was very good, was it's just a ton of mullet popping up here, Anthony, and you know, structure is a one great thing, but when you see mullet and you have a clean, you know, decent water, you have a pretty good chance of catching some fish.
That's a fact. Sometimes we'll just ride miles and miles until we see some mullet move and slow down. It may not even be a spot we normally would fish, but we'll pull up and start catching fish.
Yeah,
mullet is key. It definitely attracts fish all the time. Keeps them coming back for more.
That's another good one, and we're putting a nice box of fish together here.
That one there makes our limit. We're doing all right.
All right.
A couple of guys who didn't start off so good.
Good God.
That was fast, wasn't it?
That was really fast. That sucker hit it as soon as it hit the water. I think I'm going to try to throw there and see if I can do the same thing you just did.
It's all you, bud.
Whoops, I passed my bait off. I'll tell you one thing that we both use and have been using is two different things. Death grip jig head and that four horseman cork, and that's a deadly combination, isn't it?
It really is. When you stick a fish, you've got them.
Aaron and those guys have just done a great job with that four horseman cork. It makes a difference.
Oh yeah, it's a very unique sound, one of a kind sound, and fish come to it.
Yeah, it's a lot of people think that sometimes fishing tackle is used to hook fishermen, but that's not always the case.
Not always.
Yeah, I mean, really good stuff. Death grip jig heads, nothing's gonna come off of those when you're fishing that. And these corks have this awesome sound, that rattle, and especially for a redfish real loud like that, it's just the dinner bell for them.
It absolutely is.
Nice fish. Gets to live another day.
Yep, get back in the water.
Oh, look.
There you go.
There we go. That's a better fish there.
Perfect.
Yep. Well, we found bait, and we have found a pretty consistent redfish bite. Which is what you're gonna do when you come out here with Captain Anthony Randazzo. Look at that. And I'll tell you what, one thing about fishing with bait, I'm gonna need the pliers.
We got that.
Because that sucker inhaled it. He absolutely inhaled it. So Anthony, if somebody's coming out here, we kind of touched on this a little bit, but if somebody's coming out here and they're fishing, there's a million of these points out here. Not everyone holds fish. What's the key? I guess the main thing, if you don't really know spots that hold fish, find the bait.
Find the bait, but try to look at the land itself. If you can tell where you've got some sort of rigidity to the shoreline, like here behind the cane, we've got a grass point. Grass is growing out of the soil, so it's visibly hard ground. Fish are going to key in on stuff like that, especially with the river being high. They like the harder bottoms. I actually feel like it's a method they use to move around, sort of like Braille for a blind person. They can feel the harder bottoms versus the softer bottoms, and they're more comfortable at this time of the year in that environment.
Good point.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative.
What we're doing here today is actually pretty simple, you know, far from rocket science. We're fishing with a great four horseman cork, 30-inch leader, death grip jig head. Try to use the lighter jig heads, 1/16th, 1/8th ounce when we're fishing bait against the canes here. Important to have a good solid leader. 30-pound test is most common. Sometimes we go up a little bit higher than 30 because the canes have a lot of barnacles growing on the bases. It's very abrasive. It can break you off if you hook a big fish and it goes back in the grass. So you just want to make sure you got, you know, good healthy tackle. The rod doesn't have to be super healthy, just enough to keep the fish from running in the canes and light enough to make sure you have a good fight. We've got an assortment of plastics here. You know, you can try any color, anytime. Anything can work out here. These fish will literally eat anything that you can catch a bass on back home. It's in your tackle box. Typically come out here and throw it and catch these fish. Right now, they're keying in on bait because the water's really high on the river, the salinities are down, and it just seems to make a big difference for these fish. I've been guiding in Southeast Louisiana for 30 years now. It's just something that's in my blood. You know, I went to college, had a great job, really, really wanted to fish more than anything in the world. Didn't think I could make a living as a professional bass fisherman and fell into the guiding industry and really lucky to have, you know, landed where I am. Met some incredible people and had some great relationships developed throughout the years. And, you know, in a nutshell, there's no better feeling than riding out into the sunrise every single morning. It's the best office in the whole world.
Told you.
I'm gonna go right behind you and see if we can double up.
Yep, I mean, they are over here.
Come around your left side.
Right on that point. Yeah, you're on them right there. We got a double up right there. Come on, we got a double up right there. Got a double up. Come. I got some spots on this sucker. That blue tail meaning that they're swimming around and active in that sun. And another one. So much fun to come out here and do this. There it is. I knew the double up was coming. I knew it. I mean, is it a double though, Anthony? I mean, is it technically a double since mine was in the boat?
Technically, it might not be, but we're going to have two fish in our hands at the same time.
Okay, so yeah, as long as I keep the fish in there. I think if the fish stays in your hand and you don't go get it out the ice chest, it's technically a double.
We know they were within a minute of each other, that's for sure.
Yeah, they definitely were within a minute. But, yeah. The other thing about this that we can tell people learning to do stuff, if you find them, even though everything on this shoreline looks the same, it seems like that one spot over there seems to be where they are. It's funny how these fish can be in one little spot.
They will find a 10 by 10 box this time of the year, and you better throw in that 10 by 10 box. Sometimes it's smaller, sometimes bigger, but these fish will find the spot they want to be, and they gang up.
Well, that's going to wrap it up for another very successful morning of fishing here in Plaquemines Parish, Louisiana, in Venice with Captain Anthony Randazzo. We were able to beat the weather. We were able to not make a long boat ride for nothing and stopped on a point where we just caught redfish after redfish. Thank you, Captain Anthony Randazzo, for the outstanding accommodations, the great meals, and, of course, the great fishing today. To learn more about Plaquemines Parish, go to PlaqueminesParishTourism.com. We hope you enjoyed the show today. For Captain Anthony Randazzo and producer Jim Caesar, I'm Kevin Ford, and we'll see you next week right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.